The Hydrologic Ensemble Forecast Service, or HEFS, is part of the next generation probabilistic forecasting services from the National Weather Service. HEFS guidance supports better communication of a range of possible future river levels by providing more nuanced information on the potential magnitude and timing of hydrological events. In this video, we provide examples of how to effectively communicate the information provided by the HEFS through two river flood briefings offered over a period of 3 days by an NWS service hydrologist.
Good morning, I'm Nicole, the service hydrologist here at NWS Clarksdale. I have Mary, one of our meteorologists here as well. As always, if you have any questions during today's briefing, please put those in the chat box and we'll be sure to get them answered for you.
We have the potential for some heavy rainfall this weekend and wanted to give you all a quick briefing on what we are expecting. Heavy rainfall is likely along a slow-moving cold front, and we could see both flash flooding and river flooding in our area. We are anticipating widespread 2 to 3 inches of rain over the next 3 days, with some localized amounts up to 5 inches. Focusing first on the river flood threat, I am concerned about flooding along the Spring River at Farmville, Greensboro, and Hamden. Right now, our official single value forecast for the Spring River here at Greensboro does not show any significant rise or flooding. However, keep in mind, this forecast only includes the next 24 hours of rain, and the heaviest rain isn't expected until after that time. But we're not completely in the dark about what could happen. We have the Hydrologic Ensemble Forecast Service, or HEFS, that can help us assess the flood potential based on rainfall forecast information for the next 10 days. The HEFS graph on the right here shows us the probability of the river reaching various levels by using similar past rainfall events to predict a range of possible river levels for this current event. If we look at the next 10 days as a whole, the HEFS output gives us about a 12% chance of minor flooding here at Greensboro, and that's indicated up here in this box in the upper right-hand corner. However, the period we're most concerned about is from, looks like, Sunday, February 28th through about Wednesday, March 3rd, where the HEFS here is indicating an increased likelihood of a rise in the river levels. Now, the most probable outcome is that we remain below flood stage, but there is the potential for flooding that we need to be prepared for.
Nicole, we have a question from the Greensboro Emergency Management Director. He'd like to know how much rain was used to get that green area above flood stage.
Well, our river forecast is our best estimate of how much rain will fall, but we all know it's not a perfect forecast. In the past, when we've forecasted, say, 2.5 inches of rain in the basin, similar to what we're forecasting now, it actually rained around 1 inch a few times, perhaps 2 to 3 inches several times, and maybe even well above 3 inches a couple of times, just as a few examples. So we use a bunch of these past events to run our river model for this current event in order to simulate a large number of river forecasts that could potentially occur. We can then calculate how many of those river forecasts are at specific river levels for each time in the future, and that gives us the probabilities you see here in the colored shading. So in other words, the HEFS graph doesn't show us those individual river forecasts based on specific rainfall amounts. Instead, the top of the green area is telling us that 10% of all of those possible river forecast exceeded flood stage, which is here. So it looks like between the evening of March 2nd and through the evening of March 3rd. Now let's take a look upstream at the Spring River at Farmville. The official single value forecast is showing a rise to about 15.4 feet by Sunday morning. And that's, again, based on that 24-hour rainfall forecast of about a half to three quarters of an inch. But again, this doesn't include the heaviest rainfall that's expected over the next 3 days. Again, we can look at the HEFS graph for this location to help us see how the river might respond to the entire rainfall event. The box in the top right indicates that there is a 44% chance of reaching minor flood stage, a 26% chance of reaching moderate flood stage, and even a 10% chance of hitting major flood stage sometime within the next 10-day forecast. We can look at the graph here, and it shows us that if this flooding were to occur, it would be most likely between, looks like, tomorrow and Tuesday, March 2nd, with a crest most likely occurring here on Monday, March 1st. There is a lot of uncertainty in predicting how high that crest is going to be, though.
We've got another question. The Farmville Emergency Manager wants to know how she can use this forecast given such a wide range of possible outcomes.
Currently, there's just a lot of uncertainty in the forecast, and we don't have a lot of confidence in any one outcome. There is a good chance we won't even, you know, reach flood stage, but we can say that there is the potential for some, you know, moderate to even major flooding in the next 3 days. We're currently just uncertain exactly where that rain is going to fall and just how much, and that's why HEFS has a wide range of possible river levels. We expect the front to stall, and if the front stalls, you know, south of the Spring River Basin, we'll likely have less rainfall and a lower chance of flooding. But, you know, if it stalls right over the river basin, it's possible we could have some minor to moderate flooding along the Spring River, and we can't rule out major flooding either, although the chances for that are low.
Nicole, the Blue County Emergency Manager, is looking at the second peak and wants to know if they should be concerned about another event on March 6th and 7th.
Yes, there does appear to be another storm system on the horizon next week. There's still a lot of uncertainty, though, that far out, and we'll be watching it closely. We'll want to see what happens with this first event, since it will be a factor in how impactful next week's storm system could be. Okay, now let's look at the Spring River at Hamden. The official single value forecast is showing a small rise to what looks like 13 feet.
Thank you for joining us again today. I'm Nicole, the service hydrologist here at NWS Clarksdale. We wanted to go ahead and update everyone on what we discussed a couple of days ago, as our confidence has increased in a significant heavy rainfall and flooding event.
Both flash flooding and river flooding are ongoing already. And with another 2 to 3 inches of rain in the forecast over the next 24 hours, additional flooding is expected. Let's first look at the rain that has already fallen. The graphic here on the left shows that over the last 24 hours, there's been about 1/2 to 2.5 inches of rain within the Spring River Basin, and that has resulted in minor flooding already. The image here on the right is showing our rainfall forecast for the next 24 hours. You can see here that we are expecting another, you know, 2 to 3 inches of rain across the basin, and we could even see localized amounts to around 4 inches. So let's first focus on the Spring River at Farmville. We are already seeing minor flooding here at Farmville from yesterday's rain, and the official single value forecast shows a continued slow rise to about 31.8 feet by tomorrow afternoon before it starts falling late tomorrow night. Now, this is based on the rain that has already fallen plus our rainfall forecast for the next 24 hours. And, you know, this puts us right here just below moderate flood stage. The HEFS is showing a possibility of a second higher crest tomorrow if the heaviest rain falls over the Spring River Basin. However, if the heaviest rainfall were to miss the Spring River Basin, we may not get another crest. Overall, the HEFS is showing a 22% chance of major flooding and a 35% chance of moderate flooding focused here over the next couple of days. Further downstream, we're looking at the possibility of the Spring River flooding at Hamden. Our official single value forecast predicts river levels slightly below flood stage. Since this site is downstream and is slower to respond, there is a lot of uncertainty in the timing of the crest, and this could happen anytime between, looks like, Tuesday, March 2nd, and Thursday, March 4th. The HEFS is showing a 40% chance of reaching minor flood stage and a 29% chance of reaching moderate flood stage.
This question is from the Hamden Emergency Manager. He has an event happening at the Civic Center on the morning of March 3rd. He says the parking lot starts to flood at 35 feet, and he's wondering what is the chance of that happening.
Well, we can actually use the colored bands in the HEFS graph to help us eyeball the chance of exceeding a particular river level at a specific time. So if we're looking at your 35-foot threshold here, and we find the morning of March 3rd, which is right here, so where those intersect here is in the blue shaded area. Now, the top of the blue shading is the 25% line, and you know our 35-foot threshold is just a little bit below that. If we look further down to this dark blue line, this is the 50% line, and you know that's further away from our 35-foot threshold. So, you know, 35 feet is closer to the 25%, further from the 50%. So we can estimate that your 35-foot threshold falls at roughly 30%. In other words, there is about a 30% chance that the river will be at or above the 35-foot level the morning of March 3rd. Okay, now let's look at the Spring River at Greensboro. The official single value forecast is showing a rise.
As we've seen in these examples, the HEFS provides the opportunity for communicating a range of potential forecast outcomes for users. At the same time, we see how it is critical when presenting this product to be very clear on how it is used differently from other products and how to properly interpret it. In particular, it's especially important to emphasize that the HEFS conveys probabilities of exceeding a river level and not a single value river level forecast. Reach out to your local river forecast center for support in interpreting the information provided by the HEFS and in explaining its use to your audience.